Hello, Danny here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We're playing in the Harbinger League as a Solosov found Darkback Necromancer. And today we're gonna run the tier 9 map, The Orchard. We have Elemental Equilibrium. We're also suffering from Elemental Weakness, though our resists are, I think, high enough to negate all of that. Monsters have increased physical damage reduction, so the damage from our zombies and skeletons is going to be reduced, but Dark Pact's not going to be affected. Monsters deal 83% extra damage as fire, so they will hurt more. And as a player, I've got less armor and a reduced block chance, which, well, block chance is going to be relevant when the bone offering triggers, because of course that greatly increases my block chance. Other than that, we are generally fine. So, let's see how this works out for us.
The fruit that grows from bloody ground tastes the sweetest.
Let's double check. And indeed, our defenses are maxed out. Let's stay back, especially with these porcupines, since, well, porcupines hurt. Doesn't really matter where you are. They're porcupines, they hurt. So it seemed like something was hanging back there, but I guess there were no enemies there. Oh, tier 8 map dropped, that is nice. I'm hoping for many, many, many map drops. Though another tier 9 map would be lovely. Tier 10 would be pretty darn sweet as well. That's the fun thing. Individual map drops, they don't really matter all that much. Let's just double check that we don't leave a room behind here. Well, individual maps, now the drops might be higher, they might be lower. Just varies quite a bit. But, oh, if you get one map that just drops you three decent or relevant maps, and the next two don't drop anything, then on average you're still getting one map per map. So you're sustaining. That is something that is sometimes easier to forget. If you're on a streak where you're not really getting all that many. Okay, skeletons versus dinosaurs. It's still odd seeing those dinosaur things in Path of Exile. It just seems so out of place, but I guess it's part of the world. Okay, at least found a little bit of a dead end here. So I think I'm confusing the orchard with its garden-like layout with another map that also has a garden-like layout. So of course, the orchard sits in the bottom right side of the atlas. Yeah, exactly. So the orchard is located down here, and this is a place where I don't usually go, but I know there are maps with a similar tile layout that also look like this. Ooh, look, what's that? So let's see, what is the boss gonna be? Ooh, pretty. The goddess, or it's a bit like the shock and horror fight. Oh, ah. Oh, it's like the shock and horror fight, as in if she starts channeling, you really want to get out. Okay. She's shooting, I teleport. That seems like a decent rule. Okay. What is with that fountain? So, Break line of sight, that seems to work pretty well. There we are. Orchard completed. And we scored ourselves a belt. So definitely one of those fights where being quick on your toes, using your flame dash helps quite a bit. Let's see, this is the magnet. Increased stun duration, physical damage, bonus to strength, increased flask charges gained. And 24 to all elemental resists with 200 or more strength. Interesting. Definitely already helps you. 50 strength means you only need 150 from your base character. I'll take the Hubris Circlet. And then we'll keep going. And yeah, SS is something that is increasingly more common. We lost our zombies along the way. Well, the zombies are there mostly as a distraction during normal gameplay. They're not really meant to be staying alive all that well. So if you lose them in a fight, no fuss. We have plenty of skeletons. But while doing the area of a map, it is just enjoyable to just have an army of skeletons and zombies. That is just occupying the attention of the enemy, so enemies are less likely to go after you. It's a sense of security, even though you might not actually obtain a true security from it. Okay, there's a harbinger up there. And we're getting attacked in the flank here. Let's do a little bit with the flank so we can just stay focused. I guess we will be cursed here to just keep our attention divided. Did catch that corrupting blood I was just getting damaged by without really realizing. Ooh, and temple. I don't think I've got a temple yet, so that is wonderful. And that harbinger died. Time to claim the loot. See, temple is another tier 9, that is wonderful. Where is the temple located? Let's just double check. Temple. Oh, it's next door. So this is actually the logical next one, going from the orchard to the temple in order to progress to Malformation, which is tier 10. Wonderful. Ooh, and we got ourselves a trial of a stinging doubt. Question is this one of the two I still need, or is this one I've already done before? After we clear the area here, let's just double check the statue or the plaque. Stinging doubts. Piercing truth, spreading fear, lingering pain, stinging doubt. Okay, we've already done it. So there's only two remaining. So I'll keep this one to the end and I'll do it after I'm done clearing the remainder. And you know what? Actually, we'll just do it at the end of the map. So some people like it, some people don't. So we'll just keep it. And that way, you can decide whether you like it or not. Since most of the trials so far have been things that popped up when I was doing my daily Xana missions or just doing some warm-up maps or things like that. So not the kind of stuff that is really interesting or compelling to watch. Since at this point, now if I'm doing like a tier 5 or tier 6 map, that is, well, quite a bit below us. I mean, we're at level 86, but now as far as progress on the Atlas is concerned, we're at tier 8, tier 9. So it's not really that much of a interesting challenge to do those lower tier maps. Let's just put all the currency in the currency box. That makes it a bit easier. Okay. Let's go back. Flash repair. Another book or another lore bit thingamajig. Okay, so this is taking us back the direction where we wanna be eventually for the trial, isn't it? Or is the trial not highlighted on the map? It's not. Okay, that is annoying. You would expect those permanent features to remain marked on the map. Because it's not like a trial is suddenly just gonna pack up its bags and go. Would be odd, be interesting to see, but definitely be odd. Memory of Intrigue. So while we clear the remainder of the map, let's have a listen to that.
High Templar Vanadius and his Inquisitors paid a visit to the Academy today, closely guarding a heavy box they brought with them. When I inquired as to its origin, I was promptly reminded that such matters were none of my business, and that my only concern would be the assembly and operation of its contents. One can only assume that it came from another secret expedition to Rayclass. Upon examination of the contents, I was bewildered. The intricate golden instruments within steer the mind towards navigation tools, yet are far more refined. Imagine something akin to a sextant, or an astrolabe, but 100 times more intricate, more precise. Imagine scales and measurements with proportions and axes that defy logic. Once correctly assembled, I expect these pieces to form some kind of device. Though its purpose and function for now remain a mystery, whatever it is, this device is either the work of a madman or a genius. Perhaps both.
A madman or a genius or both. Oh, there's only 8 more monsters remaining, so they're probably gonna be in the room over here. Oh, that's... Oh, the room over there. I do like my folklores. Hello, goodbye. Tree? Nope, 3 lucky duckies. Let's head back to the trial and run it. So, stinging doubts. Let's try this. It is nice to just get the statues of the goddess as a bonus. That way, if I manage to complete all 6 trials, and I'll have plenty of statues to rerun the endgame labyrinth for the amazing amount of loot that you're supposedly be able to get from there. I think I've only done the endgame labyrinth like once or twice before, and that might have even been just only on standard league. So not even temporary standard, but actually just standard. Permanent standard league. One of the things I found is that if you just unleash your army of skeletons on the statues, that is a pretty decent way of just clearing them out. And the skeletons will be exposed to whatever traps and elements are in the area. Well, you yourself can just watch from the relative safety of wherever you are standing while you cast the skeletons. Found that to be a pretty neat side effect of this build. Yeah, that is something we kind of didn't want. Oh, yeah, they do keep coming back, the statues, with the curses. So if you don't realize that something got killed, then you might be in for a surprise. A bit of a nastier than usual surprise. Da-da-da. Of course, most of the things you can just run through, you can speed clear them, you can be less precise, less cautious, I guess. For me, it often really just depends on my mood or randomness, how I'm gonna deal with a trial. Sometimes I'm reckless, sometimes I'm extremely cautious. This guy, I think we did more towards the side of caution. And we got ourselves another offering to the goddess. I think I've completed 4 different trials so far, but I think this might be my 7th or so statue. Let's have a look. 6th. So I've had two duplicates so far. Let's see, a card. Oh, I completed this one recently. Let's have a look what we're gonna get, a unique map. If it's within our reach, then that might be a nice one to run soonish as well. Crouching Darkness, which unique map are we gonna get a corrupted version for? Olmec Sanctum. That is a lovely one. I enjoy. A couple times I've run it, I enjoyed it. Monsters have more life, they have increased damage, and the final boss drops higher level items. Presumably that helps us with some map drops, I'm not entirely sure. And a nice increased quantity. So Olmec Sanctum has a bunch of totems. I think there's a totem for each element, and then after you defeat it, you go to the center, and then they are there again with a final totem. So there's just going to be a lot of totem slaying. So we'll keep this in our collection and run it soon-ish. But with that, I'm going to thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.